Welcome to Price Lanes. This is the Bowlers Gazette Handicap Star Challenge, and tonight we have a match between Michelle Pollard and Lonzie Seymour, the winner of which will face James Bromwell, and the winner of that will go on to face the current star champion, Dave Lux Sr. This is John Thompson Jr. and Casey Galluccio bringing you the action, and Lonzie Seymour will start the match. Count for Lonzie to start the match. Lonzie will be giving up a 38 pin advantage to Michelle, who is from Seaford. Lonzie is from Wilmington. Going after the 6 pin, and he brings it in, starts the match with a spare. Pollard with a 136 average. Start the match on lane 4. Starts off with a solid Brooklyn strike. That ought to give her a lot of confidence. Settle her down. Get the butterflies away.
Her high series so far is a 535. High game, 212. She's been bowling for 3 years now.
Okay, Michelle missed the head pin to the left, a 6 pin count. The 1389, a difficult spare. Trip 4, good strike. Gives Lons 36 in the third frame with a strike in the third. Now Michelle needs to calm down a little bit. Forget the lights. Just roll the ball down there and make some marks. Use that handicap advantage. Head pin to the left again, a 7 pin count, a 136 spare.
So she's throwing a conventional ball today. It's looks like a white dot. It's 11 pounds.
Just a little too much at times. She gets one, finishes the third frame at 72. Like a better shot, and it was. She got a strike. Looked like she kept her shoulder a little straighter that time. Might be something she want to think about as she gets set to throw her shot, to remember, try to remind herself to keep her shoulder square at the foul line. Lonzie sent the ball a little wide on the right lane. He's left a very difficult spare, the 2-8-10 split. Other than throwing very hard at the 2-8 and hoping you get a lucky bounce, I really don't know any way to make this. Okay, that's a bad frame for Lonzi. Didn't pick up any pin count on his split. Gets him 60 through the fourth frame.
Both bowlers here today, both started bowling when their parents got them interested in. So let's hear it for the parents again.
Yeah, good old mom and dad, they started a lot of bowlers. Little light that time for Lonzi, almost shook the 5-7 on a wall shot. Relative leave is an easy spare leave, bring the 7 pin in. Giving away 38 pins to Michelle, he can't afford too many misses. And good cover, good cross alley shot at the 7 pin.
Both bowlers here today are single.
It appears that when she drops her shoulder way down at the release point, she really throws a bad shot. Misses the head pin entirely to the left. Michelle. It gives her 54, 92, I'm sorry, 92 in the fourth with a spare up. We'll take a short break and bring right back with the rest of the match. Welcome back to Price Lanes on our first match of the Bowlers Gazette Handicap Star Challenge. Michelle Pollard against Lonzi Seymour.
Almost tripped the 10.
Stubborn 10 pin. It waved at her, but it wouldn't fall down. Seems like every time she keeps her shoulders square at the foul line, she makes a very good shot. Gives Michelle 111 through the fifth. About halfway through the game here, and Lonzi's going to have to make a little run at her.
32 pin difference.
Good shot on the 10 pin. The loser of this match will get $25. And the winner gets to continue on with the hopes of getting to the star, current star, which is Dave Lux Sr., with a chance to win $100. Just missed a 2-pin, easy 9-pin spare.
That's going to hurt Lonzi. He's going to need a lot of spares to catch her now.
That's his second open in the last three frames. He's going to have to come out with a strike or two here, I think, to catch Michelle. Seven count, 6-9-10.
Lonzi's favorite bowler is Earl Anthony. I know a lot of bowlers that have him as their favorite.
And a good spare shot there. Yeah, Earl is everybody's favorite. There's no doubt about that. Sorry to see him retire. Now I think Lons could use a little bit of Earl out there to get back in this match. Through the sixth frame, Michelle has 130 to Lons' 88. Pins is a lot of pins to pick up in three frames. Michelle smoking now, that's four straight marks for her.
She is bowling a good game considering what her average is.
That was a good shot. Tripped the four out. Really put the pressure on Lonzi with that shot. Good shot by Lonzi. Shook the four, wiggled at him, but it wouldn't fall down. The spare in Lons is 43 pins down going into the ninth frame.
It's a tough nail to come back.
Good cross out spare shot.
Lons definitely needs some strikes. Pin difference. Michelle's working on a strike, Lonzi's on a spare.
Went for it. Aggressive shot. Trip four into the nine. That's an aggressive shot. It's a good ball. Keeps his hopes alive with that one. You're right, Michelle is bowling an excellent game. 136 average, and she only has two opens in the eight frames. That's very good. Break there, high hit, left to 6-7-10 split.
Looks like Lonzi has a strikeout and hit Michelle. Opens here in the 10th. If she marks, looks like she might ace the game.
Okay, fell off in the gutter with that one. Got seven pins in that frame. Michelle has 174 through nine frames. If Michelle can mark in the 10th, you're exactly right, Casey. If she can mark in the 10th with good count, Mr. Seymour cannot catch her. So many of these games, it always boils down to the very last shot. Nine count left to five pin. swings a spare end. Real pressure shot by Michelle. Needs four pins to shut Lonzi out. That's if my addition's correct. That looks like a pretty good shot. An eight count on the last ball gives Michelle a 192. Lonzi strikes out, I believe he'd finish at 187.
Looked like Lonzi didn't even want to finish.
Now Lonzi's had trouble with that right hand lane the whole match.
Sure had. He had two opens on that side. Only two opens in this game.
If he brings a spare in and gets a strike, he'll finish in the 160s. Lonzi's going to be the loser of the first match. He's going to get $25 for his troubles, which will ease the pain of those two opens a little bit. Michelle is going to go on in the Handicap Star Challenge, and she's going to be facing Jim Bromwell in the next match. So she's got the first game under her belt. She's got a chance to win $50, if not more.
Lonzi's last ball goes out with a strike.
Here we go with a strike. Finally solved that lane. Lonzi finishes at 167. First match loser to Michelle Pollard, who had 192. We'll be back with more matches very soon. This is the second match in the Bowlers Gazette Handicap Star Challenge. Michelle Pollard has advanced to the second round after defeating Lonzi Seymour, and she's going to be taking on James Bromwell in this match.
Loser of this match will win $50.
Michelle starts off leaving the 310 baby split. Michelle will have a 27-pin handicap advantage. Her 136 average against Mr. Bromwell's 174 average. Excellent start to the match. Makes the 310 baby split. Jim Bromwell's been bowling 3 years in league play, averaging 174. So notice he's left-handed, using a 16-pound LT fingertip. Starts off with a very bad break, leaving the 8-10 split on a Brooklyn hit. Jim's high game is 258, his high series is 628. Son Jimmy bowls in the Bryce Lane's junior bowling program. Gets the one pin, gives him a total of 9 in the first frame. The winner of this match will advance to the championship match against the current star, Dave Lux Sr. A chance to win $100. And to continue on, win much more. Looks a little tight. 3-pin count on that shot. gets six more on the second shot. That gives him a total of 18 through the second frame. And keep in mind, he's already spotting Michelle 27 pins. So Jim really can't afford any more misses.
That was a very bad start on his part.
Bad ball. Michelle got two pins on that particular delivery.
30 pin lead by Michelle, the end of one.
Gets five more for a total of seven, gives a 46 through the second frame. Appeared like her thumb might have stuck in both of those shots. Gets a little hot out there with those TV lights shining on you. She might be experiencing a little bit of trouble with her thumb swelling up. Better shot that time. Nine count, left to five pin. As I said before in an earlier match, every time she keeps her shoulders square at the line, she seems to throw a good ball. Should cover it, and it does. Good shot in the third for Michelle. Might be wise if Jimmy would start up here now. Not necessarily getting a strike, but he needs to at least start marking. Dangerously far behind already in this match. Seven count, way right with that shot. 1-2-9 spare to pick up.
Both bowlers here have been bowling for 3 years, each of them. Mr. Brownwell, he's married. He has a son named Jimmy. He also bowls here at Price Lanes. He's 12 years old.
There's Jimmy's first mark in the match. Maybe that'll settle him down a little bit and he can get started here. Okay, there's the first strike of the match for Jim. He's smiling and he's going to take it even though he feels like it was a bad shot. You don't ever give them back once you knock them down. Gives him 38 through the third frame, strike in the fourth. Leaves the 136. Gives her 63 through the third frame. Michelle has placed second in a Pepsi tournament and has placed first in a women's doubles tournament in the last year. Just missed that spare. Here's Michelle 72 through the fourth frame. Thank you. 7 pin count for Michelle. She's all of a sudden lost the range on the head pin. This time it's the 129.
Here's a little miscellaneous item. Mr. Bromwell started bowling because of his son. A little reverse there.
Reverse action is usually the other way around.
Yes.
Sons start because of dad. I'm just going to show you old dogs are never too old to learn a new trick. Now Michelle's having a little trouble with her spare shots now. It's two straight 7 counts with 2 on a fill ball. Gives her 81 through 5 frames. We'll take a short break right here. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the Handicap Star Challenge. It's John Thompson Jr. and Casey Galuccio. Second round match between Jim Bromwell and Michelle Pollard.
Jim just doubled in the 5th frame. And now he's going to try for the turkey on lane 3.
Likes that Brooklyn side. That gives him a turkey in the 6th frame. He's put in some pressure on Michelle now. She's going to have to retaliate. Get some marks here. The loser of this match will win $50. So you won't go home sad, even if you do manage to lose the game. And the winner will go on to meet the current star champion, Dave Lux Sr. Shot at $100. That was an excellent shot by Michelle. A stinger on the wrap 10.
It would be good if she makes this pair here, because Jim does have a triple over top of her. Even though he's trailing, it's pretty close to the match now.
Just missed a 10, just missed it. Gives Michelle 90 in a 6 frame. She's going to have to find her spare touch in a hurry.
Those 3 opens in a row are really going to hurt her.
Looks like a pretty good shot. Gets 9 out of him, it leaves a 3 pin. Broke the drought. Finally got her spare in the 7th frame after 3 straight opens. Jimmy's on a roll here, coming into the 7th frame with a turkey. That was an excellent shot right in the pocket. Gives him a 4 bagger. That's put Jim in the lead. He now has 98 in the 5th frame with a double working. A little high with that shot, left at 247. 7 pin count. He's in 125 through 6.
Gives him 35 pins. A
couple strikes in a row can really make up a lot of pins. Not a bad break on that spare. He took 2 on it. Gives him 153 in the ninth frame. Michelle still has a chance in this match. Another 9-pin count, left to 3-pin again. Picks it up again. In order for Michelle to have any realistic hopes of going on for the $100, she cannot afford any more misses in this match. Side, 7-pin count. It's her 126 in the eighth frame, versus Jim Bromwell's 153 in the eighth frame.
27 pins down.
Coincidence in that is that Jimmy has made up the 27 pins that he gave her, plus going in front 27 pins. It's a 54-pin swing. All in those 4 strikes in a row that he got. 2-4-5 combination, and she makes it. Very nice shot by Michelle. Making that spare still keeps her hopes up just a little bit. Pin count for Mr. Bromwell. I left a 3-pin on a light hit. Jimmy's really having a problem with his spares tonight. 162 through 9.
1 out of 5. 4 of it's 1 spare and 4 strikes in a row.
If he can get a mark in the 10th frame and good count, I believe he will shut Michelle out. Best she can get if she strikes out is 176. Left a big 7-10 on that hit. Something was kind to Jim, rolled a 10-pin out. Left him a 7-pin, which is not necessarily the easiest shot in the world for a left-hander. And Jim was not able to pick it up. Missed 4 or 5 out of his 6 spare shots this game. Still finished with 171, doing mostly in part to his 4 strikes in a row in the middle of the game. And Michelle really needs a strike, 2 strikes right here. Going for the head pin. There it is.
She got the first one.
She got the first one. That was a real pressure shot for that young lady. Gives her 146 in this ninth with a strike. Mr. Bromwell finished the game at 171.
She has the strike here. This is where all it is. This is where all the marbles play.
at least $50 worth of them.
Yeah.
Concentration is on her face. She went for the head pin and left a three pin. And that very aggressive try by Michelle. She's going to finish at 166 with the spare.
Very good comeback by Michelle.
Sure was. She finished that game out with three spares and a strike.
Still above her average, too.
Okay, Michelle's going to finish at 166, losing the second round match to Jim Bromwell, who had 171. She'll pick up $50 and go home to Seaford with a little bit of a smile on her face. We'll be back with another exciting match. Bryce Lanes for the Bowlers Gazette Handicap Star Challenge final match between the current star, Dave Lux Sr., against James Bromwell. It's John Thompson Jr. and Casey Galluccio bringing you the action. Dave Lux is going to start the match on lane four.
Currently has an average of 172. Been bowling for 6 years.
And he starts out with a trip six Brooklyn strike. His opponent, Jim Bromwell, who is the left-hander, is probably wondering what's going on here. Jim has a seven pin handicap advantage in this match. And he returns the favor by going Brooklyn for his strike to start the match. The left-hander is playing right-hander, and the right-hander is playing left-hander, it looks like.
Makes sense.
Why not? Fair is fair. They once told me, one of my coaches a long time ago once told me, you have to hit the head pin to strike, son. Doesn't matter where. Loser of this match will win $75. Winner of the match will win $100 with a chance to go on and defend his title in the weeks to come. In the second frame, Jim Bromwell threw a good shot in his pocket and left a 6-8 split. Excellent try at that split. I thought James was going to slide that pin over. Gives Jim 33 through the second frame after adding his seven pin advantage in. Both fellas went for their pocket in the second frame, and both fellas left rather nasty-looking splits. It's 7-10 for Dave. Dave's been bowling 6 years. He's using a black angle 16-pound fingertip tonight. His high game is 264. High series 723. Picks up one on the 7-10 split, gets him 28 through the second frame. Excellent shot. He really trusted that shot, threw it way wide. Managed to trip the two pin off the wall. It's exciting to watch. I'm sure he's thankful he got that strike. It's a little bit lucky to get the 2-1 a trip off. Jim Mancer's back with a Brooklyn strike of his own in the third frame. Both guys are matching each other shot for shot.
Looks like monkey see, monkey do here.
Yeah. And they each have a strike in the first and third frame, and they each had a split in the second frame. Excellent shot, solid in his pocket and left it wrapped 10 pin. After those two Brooklyn strikes, he made an excellent shot, left the 10 pin. And he's still laughing, that's good. Oh, now that was what you call trick shot. He's really smiling now, dropped a 10-pin sideways on his spare shot. Gives Jim Bromwell 53 through the third frame with a spare in the fourth. In his previous match, Jim had trouble with spares. And he's still struggling a little bit on his spare shots in this match. Seven pin count. Dave is really giving that black angle a lot of room. Dave Lux, 48, the third, spare up. Giving that ball a lot of room. Last time on that lane, came back light just about like that shot and tripped a two off the wall. This time on lane four, he's giving himself a real problem with a 2-10 split. One on the conversion gives him 75 through five frames. We'll take a short break here and be right back with the conclusion of this match. Welcome back to Price Lanes. Conclusion of the Handicaps Star Challenge match between Jim Bromwell and Dave Lux Sr. It's a 9-pin fill for Jim, leaves a 5-pin, gives him 72 in the fourth frame. The winner of this match not only will win $100, but continue on as a star for as many weeks as he can continue to win, which means his winnings are unlimited. The loser of this match will win $75 and go home with a smile on his face, I'm sure. Jim brings in a 5-pin. Opened himself up just a little bit of a lead over Dave. Light hit leaves the 3-5.
15-pin lead by Jim now.
Okay, good spare shot for Mr. Bromwell. After struggling in the last match and missing his first spare of this match, he's made three in a row. They're halfway through the game. Dave needs to get something started here. He doesn't want to fall too far behind.
Dave is a 700 bowler. His highest series ever is a 723.
Excellent shot.
His highest game was a 264.
Looks like Dave made an adjustment on lane three. Did not send the ball quite as far to the right. Let's see if he makes the same adjustment on lane four, which has been very low two frames, two times in a row. Once getting very lucky on a trip two for a strike. Second time wasn't so lucky when he left a 210 split. See if he makes an adjustment here in a crucial part of the game. Not quite as far out with that ball that time. Seemed to have picked up his mistake of sending it too far to the right. It's first double of the match. Makes this match less than one mark apart.
Uh-oh.
Seven pin count, I believe. They have a mother-in-law pin on that one. That looks like the 397. Jimmy got a little pass that time. Lost the ball right at his feet at the foul line. And that swings old momentum, I guess you would say, back to Dave Lux. And doubly bad as Jim did not pick up any extra count on his second shot. He's in 114 through the seventh frame.
Well, that puts Dave in the driver's seat now.
Sure does. High hit for Jim. Leaves himself with 4-7-8 spare to bring in. As Jim was telling me before we went on for this match, had played a lot of softball yesterday, and it was catching up to him. He was feeling kind of sore. That may be why he's having a little trouble with his spare shots.
He is having trouble with those spare shots, though.
That's his third open this game. Gives Jim 123 in the eighth frame. The tide has turned, I think, to Dave Lux, who, after getting the first double of the match, was able to sit there and watch his opponent go flat two frames in a row. Tentative with that shot. Ball hooked high for him. Left a 3-6 spare combination. He has regained the lead now. Good spare shot. Gives Dave Lux 123 through 7. With a spare in the eighth. Jim Bromwell has 123 in the eighth, working on an open. So the current star champion has the game well in hand at the moment. Everything's going in his favor.
Down to 14 pin lead. Depends on what's going to get on the spare here.
Good shot. Ninth frame hammer ball gets the strike, gives him 143 through 8 with the strike. 20 pin lead, 20 pin decibel. facing Jim Bromwell as he comes up in the ninth frame.
Needs a strike here.
And he was aggressive, but he pulled the ball. Pulled it up high, left to 4-6.
Now we'll put Jim farther down in the hole.
He's going to have to strike out in the 10th. That gives Jim Bromwell 131 in the 9th. If he could strike out for 161, he would at least make Dave show up for the 10th frame. And 9 count on a Brooklyn hit left the 8th pin up there.
So it looks like Dave won the $100 and will continue. And Jimmy Bromwell takes home $75. He connects for despair. And it looks like pin count from here.
I'm sure Jimmy would have liked to have defeated the champion and gone on, but there's nothing to frown about when you can go home with $75. He's going to wind up with a 6 count and shoot 147 in his championship match. All Dave has to do really is take his time, go up there and throw the ball, and don't hurt anything. He will return as our Star Challenge champion. Win $100 for tonight's work. Chance to win $100 for as long as he can keep winning. A little high on his shot in the 10th frame, left to 3-6-10. Spare cover in the 10th, hitting 163 through 9. A 183 total if he can knock all 10 down with the final shot. So Dave Lux Sr., after defeating Steve French to win his first championship, his first $100, has defeated Jim Bromwell here tonight to win another $100. Chance to go on and defend his title for just as long as he possibly can. Finishes with a 6 count and a 179 to 147 victory for Dave Lux Sr. over Jim Bromwell Jr. And we'll be back with more bowling action.